Alright guys, let's talk about the next topic in logical reasoning. The topic is statement courses of action. Now what do you exactly have in this? Alright guys, let's talk about the next topic, statement courses of action. This topic again is like statement assumption that comes for 5 marks in your CET. So it's a very important topic. Now the way we had rules and statement assumptions, the way we defined them, we'll define rules and courses of action too. Okay, however, course of action. Now, course of action means you got to take some action. Okay, so which means there has to be a problem or a situation. Okay, now problem or a situation, and your action must be focused on this two things. Okay, either it should focus on solving the problem, or it should focus on your action should be focused on these two things, and which means either it should focus on solving the problem, okay, or it should focus on taking care of the situation, alright? So basically your action in course of action is always about solving or taking care. Which means your action in course of action is all about solving the problem, okay, and giving a perfect solution. So for solutions, you need to take care of a few things. For example, the first and most important rule, the solution must be viable. Viable means you should be able to do that, okay? It shouldn't be a solution which is not possible at all, okay? As we move ahead with the examples, we'll talk about more and more rules of course of action as we did in the assumptions class, okay? So first thing, course of action must be viable, which is basically it should be within your limits, okay, within your reach, I would say, okay. So first rule is course of action must be viable. The next rule is it should solve the problem. Obviously, now when you talk about problem, you must solve it, and the solution must be almost instant and not far-fetched, okay. Keep that in mind. The first rule is it should be viable. Next, it should solve the problem. Third, it should not be harsh. So you cannot have harsh courses of actions, okay? You have to have mild courses of action. I'll speak about harshness and mildness in a while as we move ahead with the handout, okay? So first, it should be viable. Next, it should solve the problem. Third, it should not be harsh. And the fourth and the most important rule is again the utopian rule, okay? You always understand and keep yourself in the utopian state and then take a course of action, which means it's all about good and kind and benevolent, okay? So let's say your friend gets run over by a car while he's crossing the street. You shouldn't just pull out the car driver and bash him up, okay? So bashing up, okay, and like hitting somebody and just taking action, vigilante, I would say, vigilante is not a valid course of action, alright? So these are the four course of action rules, okay? If we have more rules, we'll keep on adding. I'll repeat these rules. Number one, viable. Number two, it should solve the problem almost instantly. Number three, it should not be harsh. And number four, the utopian state, alright? Let's have a look at the examples one by one, okay? And understand, let's have a look at the examples. So I'll be forwarding this handout. This handout already has the rules written down. If you can just see, it should be valid, it should help solve the problems, blah blah blah, okay. Now again, this will be static. A is 1 follows, B is 2 follows, C is either or, D is neither nor, and E is both. Now keep in mind, in course of action you will not have either or normally. The reason being, course of action is always a solution, so definitely any solution will be a solution, and any non-viable solution will not be a solution, so it cannot have either or, which means, okay, so if you have two solutions that are valid, you will probably mark both over either or, because you cannot have exclusive solutions. All right let's focus on the questions. Question number one, okay, the inmates of JLX are very dangerous people. Now what is the problem? The problem is, focus on the problem statement, the inmates are very dangerous is a problem, okay? Now let's see what you can do. More security personnel should be deployed to guard the jail. Yes, because you need more security personnel. Why? Because they are dangerous people, so you need more security personnel to guard them. Fair point. It is a valid course of action. Some inmates should be shifted to a different jail. No, it doesn't solve the problem. Okay, why? Because if they are dangerous people, shifting them may not be viable. Number one, may not be viable. And number two, you may or may not, you don't know about whether the new GL that you're shifting to, they can create problems there too. So it doesn't make a lot of sense, okay? So it's not a valid course of action that in that manner, all right? So in this case, a very straightforward one, this was the rule used out here was it should solve the problem, okay? Let's look at the next statement, statement 2. The power supply on state X is terribly poor. Now power supply is poor, okay? If the power supply in a state, particular state is poor, what do? Okay, the best part in CET is you need not find out your own solutions. You already have the options in front of you, okay? Number one, the concerned authority should immediately take measure to protect power theft, pilferage, etc. Yes, because the power supply is already poor, okay, that's the problem. So you need to take care of any theft or any pilferage taking place, okay? Now, if you go to tier 3 cities, this is tier 3 places in India, this is something that does really happen all the time, okay? There is theft of power, there is pilferage of power. People actually have this kind of ropes, you know, they... Doesn't matter, don't speak this. Okay, fine. So, definitely one is a course of action. Number two, government should buy excess power from the neighboring states. Now, neighboring states... Now, this is a very important rule again in course of action, okay? I'd like to highlight on this rule. Now, this rule means... There should be a past experience of the same. Which means something like this must have happened in the past, okay? And you know about it. So it's more like a current affair, not really a current affair, but a generic thing that normally happens. So if you've seen something like that before, any past experience that has been successful in the execution, okay, will definitely be a course of action. So again, we've redefined the fifth rule. The fifth rule is there should be a past experience. There must be a past experience. So let's say you have a terrorist attack. What should be the immediate course of action? Inform the authorities, take some security measures, etc. Because you've had a past experience of a terrorist attack. Okay? Alright. So coming back. So this is something which is a past experience. Government has done this a lot of times. They buy excess power from the others, from the other neighboring states. They naturally tend to borrow power. And that's fairly possible. So the answer is both are implicit, which is nothing but option E. So I told you, keep in mind these options. A will be one only, B will be two only. C is either or, D is neither nor, and E is both. Alright. Next question. The teenager was arrested by the police for taking drugs. Now the teenager was arrested because he was consuming drugs. What should be? The problem is he was taking drugs. Okay, let's focus. The teenager should be meted with corporal punishment. Now corporal punishment is what I spoke about. It should not be harsh. Now this is a harsh course of action. Okay, don't punish them. Don't give them a corporal punishment as such. Okay, you can just threaten them, warn them, but don't be harsh. Okay, so you cannot be harsh. Harshness is never a course of action. The next course of action, teenager should be sent to a drug rehabilitation center. Yes, because he was consuming drugs. He was caught consuming drugs. He must be considered to be sent to a rehabilitation center. So two is valid, one is not. All right, let's move ahead. Okay, corruption has become rampant in our society. So the problem is corruption being rampant, course of action. All corrupt should be brought to the book. Now this is something which is not viable. Okay, for bringing all corrupt people to the book, you must know how many people are corrupt first and foremost. You must know who all are corrupt. Okay, so this is not viable. And that is why it cannot be a course of action. Number two, we should all strive hard to make our society corruption free. Yes, this is something which is utopian. So this is utopian kind of a thing. You must strive hard to make a society free from corruption, social inequality and gender discrimination, etc, etc. All these are utopian ideas. So definitely the utopian idea works here. Option B follows, one doesn't. Okay, floods may create havoc in the country this year too. Let's next look at the next statement. Fifth one says, floods can create havoc this year as well. So what should you do exactly? The government should be on alert to evacuate flood affected victims. Definitely. Okay, they should be on alert. Alright, people should not be afraid of floods. This is something very vague. So definitely two is not a course of action. However, one is. Yeah, fair point. Then that's how it is. Let's look at the sixth statement. The state government has decided to declare Kala Azar as a notifiable disease under the Epidemics Act. Now, if you want, you can find out what is Kala Azar. Okay, just for your information. Family members of the neighbor of the patient are liable to be punished in case they don't inform the state authorities. What are they saying? They are declaring this disease as epidemic. Okay, and family members or neighbors who don't report will be punished. Simple as that. Okay. Something that does happen normally. Okay, so Kala Azar is now into the epidemic sect of diseases, the epidemic state. I mean, Kala Azar is now into the epidemic set of diseases. Okay, so family members must be, the family members should be in, should be like, family members should take the initiative to inform. Okay, let's look at the course of action. Effort should be made effectively to implement the act. Yes, because they have now made it an epidemic, so there must be efforts by, like, you know, you should communicate this message very clearly that Kala Azar is an epidemic. So fair point. Effectively implementation, effective implementation is a very fair point in this. All right, cases of punishment should be propagated through mass media so that more and more people are aware of the stern action. Yes, because this is like setting an example. So let's say somebody gets caught not informing the government about one of their family members affecting from Kala Azar. You'll probably take a course where, you know, you'll punish the family members or maybe just take some stern actions against them. Okay. And you must propagate this through mass media. This is what happened, so that the others, okay, this is like setting an example. So that's perfectly fine. Alright, so the answer in this case will be both are conclusions. E. Okay, next, look at the next statement. Every year at the beginning or the end of monsoon, we have some cases of conjunctivitis, but this year it seems to be a major epidemic with witnessed nearly after 4 years. So now every year you see conjunctivitis, but this year it's a major epidemic because a lot of people have got it. So what do you must do? So you have to prevent conjunctivitis from spreading more, right? Let's see the course of action. They have mentioned precautionary measures should be taken after every 4 years. Now after every 4 years is something that is vague. Precautionary measures must be taken immediately. I told you the course of action must be immediate. It should solve the problem immediately. So this is like you setting up a rule where you every 4 years you'll do a checkup. So it's not really a course of action. Second, people should be advised to drink boiled water during winter season. Now that again is a little vague course of action, doesn't make a lot of sense. So none of the course of actions follow. Alright. Let's look at the next question. So statement number 8. A recent study shows that children below 5 die in cities of developing countries mainly of diarrhea and parasitic intestinal worms. What are they focusing on? Children below 5, number 1 is a focus. Developing countries die of diarrhea and parasitic intestinal worms. Alright, let's look at the course of action. Government of the developing country should take adequate measures to improve the hygienic conditions of cities. Yes. The government must take initiatives to improve is perfectly fine a course of action. Okay, anything which is utopian, anything which is solving the problem immediately, any initiative, okay, is always a course of action. Okay, next course of action. Children below 5 of developing countries need to be brought under constant medication. Yes, this is again solving the problem. So the answer is both of them are course of action. Alright, let's look at the 9th statement. One of the problems faced by food processing industry is the irregular supply. Okay, now food processing industry, okay, you might know this industry very well. Okay, the problem with this industry is irregular supply. So because of the irregular supply of raw material, there's a lot of issue. Let's see what the course of action says. Government should regulate the supply of raw material for food processing industry. Yes, I told you, anything that can be regulated, initiated and viable, okay, is a definite course of action. Government should announce attractive package to ensure regular supply of raw material. The producer of raw material not getting a reasonable price. Now, this is what we don't know about. Whether they are getting a reasonable price or there's a problem with the distribution channel. Okay. So, we cannot really comment. So, the answer definitely is the first one is valid. The second one is not. Most of the development plans develop on paper only. Okay. So, they're saying most of the development plans, they're just on paper. They don't go further. The in charge should be instructed to supervise the field work regularly. Yes, because they're just on paper. There's no field work. There's no practical implementation happening. The in charges must be instructed. The supply of paper to said department should cut short. This is very vague again. So the answer is only one is valid. Now, how much does it matter if you supply them paper or not? Anyway, come back. So that's how it works. So I hope you got this 10 statements and course of action in place. In the next video, we'll solve 10 more and try to develop a little more rules. That's it for now. Thank you very much. I hope you had a great time watching this video and hope you learned and you could implement this again. So I'll repeat the 5 rules. First, it should be viable, should solve the problem, should not be harsh. Keep in mind the utopian rule and the past experience. Okay. Thank you very, very much.